Yeah, Terry Seymour is one of 17 people who were rushed here to Lawrence Memorial Tuesday evening when an EF3 tornado touched down in Douglas County before strengthening to an EF4. He says he's lucky to be alive.
It was pretty brutal, pretty violent.
Terry Seymour was driving to his house in Ottawa, Kansas Tuesday evening when he got a text from his wife telling him that a rain-wrapped tornado was nearby.
That was at 621.
Not even 10 minutes later, and the 47-year-old dad was dialing 911 for help.
There should be the break, according to what the orthopedic surgeon told me.
Seymour came face to face with the storm as it crossed K-10 east of Lawrence.
I guess I was scared, but I was more in survival mode.
He says when he got out of his Jeep to take cover in a ditch, the wind threw him like a rag doll.
Even halfway down in the ditch, I was still getting clobbered with the winds and the rain.
He thought he might be better protected from the elements if he crawled back near his vehicle, but the SUV went airborne.
I saw the Jeep lift off the ground, and it went over my head, and my first thought was, this is just like in the movies.
The Jeep came crashing down, breaking Seymour's shin bone before it rolled further down the hill.
And as soon as it happened, I knew it was broke because I lifted my leg up and it flopped.
Once the winds died down, Seymour says a good Samaritan named Tracy stopped and waited with him until EMS arrived.
I laid outside of her car and she comforted me.
Doctors had to insert a rod below his knee to stabilize the broken bone.
If it had landed anyplace else beside my leg, I don't think I would be here.
His son and wife are happy he's alive and in good spirits.
I think he's pretty tough.
Seymour's just thankful that they weren't in the Jeep with him.
That would have been a much harder situation to deal with.
Now, it's unclear when Seymour will be back on his feet. However, he is expected to make a full recovery. He says looking back, he should have stopped sooner rather than continuing to drive before the storm caught up with him. Zach Summers, Fox 4 News.